What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. A lot of software engineers struggle with system design interviews or SDIs primarily because of three reasons. One, the unstructured nature of SDIs, where they are asked to work on an open-ended design problem that doesn't have a standard answer. Two, their lack of experience in developing large-scale systems. And three, they did not prepare for SDIs. Just like coding interviews, candidates who haven't put a lot of effort to prepare for SDIs mostly perform poorly, especially at top companies like Google, Facebook, Amazon, Microsoft, etc. In these companies, candidates who don't perform above average have a small chance of being picked. Therefore, today we'll lay out a template, a step-by-step approach to solve any system design problem. Let's go through these steps. Step 1. Clarification of the requirements. It is always a good idea to ask questions about the exact scope of the problem you are solving. Design questions are mostly open-ended and they don't have one correct answer. That's why clarifying ambiguities early in the interview is critical. Candidates who spend enough time discussing with the interviewer the end goals of the system always have a better chance to be successful in the interview. Let's expand this with an actual example of designing an Instagram-like service. Here are some questions for designing Instagram that should be answered before moving on to the next steps. Will users of our service be able to post pictures and follow other people? Should we also design to create and display the user's timeline? Will posts contain photos and videos? Are we focusing on the back end only, or are we developing the front end too? Will users be able to search posts? Do we need to display hot trending topics? Will there be any push notification for new posts? All such questions will determine what our end design will look like. Step 2. System interface and APIs definition. Define what APIs are expected from the system. This will not only establish the exact contract expected from the system and the interviewer, but will also ensure we haven't gotten any requirements wrong. Some examples for our Instagram-like service will be: post a picture that takes in a user, their details, the data in question, the location, the timestamp, etc. Generate a timeline that takes the user, their details, the current time, etc. Mark post as favorite, which also takes in the user and the post ID. Step 3. Back of the envelope estimation. It is always a good idea to estimate the scale of the system we're going to design. This will also help later when we will be focusing on scaling, partitioning, load balancing, and caching. To do that, a few questions should be answered, such as: what scale is expected from the system, such as the number of new posts, the number of post views, the number of timeline generations per second, etc. How much storage will we need? We will have different numbers if users can have photos and videos in their posts. What network bandwidth usage are we expecting? This will help us decide how to manage traffic and balance load between servers. Step 4. Define a data model. Defining the data model early will clarify how data will flow among different components of the system. Later, it will guide towards data partitioning and management. We should be able to identify various entities of the system, how they will interact with each other, and different aspects of data management like storage, transportation, encryption, etc. The user, post, follower, favorite post are some potential entities for our Instagram-like service. Additional questions to answer in this step are: which database system should we use? Will NoSQL like Cassandra best fit our needs, or should we use a MySQL like solution? What kind of block storage should we use to store photos and videos? Step 5. High level design. In this step, try to draw a block diagram with 5 to 6 boxes representing the core components of the system. For Instagram, at a high level, we will need multiple application servers to serve all the read-write requests with load balancers in front of them for traffic distributions. If we're assuming that we will have a lot more read traffic as compared to write, and since writes will be picture uploads that may consume all available connections as uploading is a slow process compared to read, we can decide to have separate servers for handling these scenarios. On the back end, we need an efficient database that can store all the posts and can support a huge number of reads. We will also need a distributed file storage system for storing photos and videos. Step 6. Detailed design. Now dig deeper into two or three components. The interviewer feedback should always guide us to what parts of the system need further discussion. We should be able to present different approaches, their pros and cons, and explain why we would prefer one approach to the other. Remember, there is no single answer. The only important thing is to consider trade-offs between different options while keeping system constraints in mind. While diving deeper into the components, try to answer questions specific to the given system requirements, such as: since we will be storing a massive amount of data, how should we partition our data to distribute it to multiple databases? Should we try to store all the data of a user on the same database? What issue could it cause? How will we handle hot users who post a lot or follow lots of people? Since users' timeline will contain the most recent and relevant posts, should we try to store our data in such a way that is optimized for scanning the latest posts? How much and at which layer should we introduce cache to speed things up? What components need better load balancing? Step 7. Identifying and resolving bottlenecks. Try to discuss with the interviewer as many bottlenecks as possible and different approaches to mitigate them. Is there any single point of failure in our system? What are we doing to mitigate it? Do we have enough replicas of the data so that if we lose a few servers, we can still serve our users? Similarly, do we have enough copies of different services running such that a few failures will not cause total system shutdown? How are we monitoring the performance of our servers? Do we get alerts whenever critical components fail or their performance degrades? In short, preparation and being organized during the interview are the keys to be successful in system design interviews. The steps we discussed during this video should guide you to remain on track and cover all the different aspects while designing a system. Stay tuned for the next video of the series in which we will start applying the above steps to design a few popular system designs in design interviews. So, that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.